This is Abe and Steve. Called Three Sides, despite its simply simple design. The bone clicker, known dead as the Newton's Cradle, isn't just simply an office toy, it's fantastic, an elegant demonstration, exposing a list of the fundamental principles of physics, the three means of law of the work, being conservation of energy and momentum, the final being friction, also looking at kinetic and potential energy, and don't forget elastic and inelastic collisions, probably known as Newton's Cradle, but not even better him, just more British guys and wit looking to show the world an awesome trick, John Wallace, Christopher Wren, and Christopher Hugin showing off the principle behind the cradle, showing the conservation of momentum in it, being F=ma, alright? Even though these guys were before Isaac and his laws of physics and his neat inventions, he was more famous than so. He has more credentials to claim this fame and honor. To be honest, it's pretty simple. Even though for such an ingenious contraption, two crossbars that are parallel, attached to a heavy base holding up the strings of an invented triangle with a blaze, so the balls only has one plane of motion, the ball should be the same mass and weight. If it's not, you could be pretty screwed up. This is supposed to show conservation of energy and mass, both of which involve mass. So if you involve one bigger than the other, how are you supposed to show the physics behind it? The balls of which are supposed to be elastic. Elastic, you ask? What could it be? I'm about to tell you, so clean your ears, so get ready. The song's about to take off. Science class. Call 3. So elasticity is the ability to change shape without losing energy. For the balls to be elastic, meaning it can go longer, and longer means better. And that's not what she said. Capiche? It should be the same density too, so that it doesn't interfere with energy transfer between the singing balls. The conservation of energy, the main point behind all this. Energy can't be destroyed or created, but can change shape. And the Newton cradle shows that perfectly. The energy switching between kinetic and potential effortlessly. At rest, the balls have zero of either energy. But as you lift the ball upward, it gains potential because of gravity. As it's falling, the potential changes to kinetic energy. And once it hits the next ball, it falls back to rest with zero. But where's that energy go? That's right, the ball that it just hit. Down the line it goes, hitting that last ball, and watch it go. But you may be asking yourself, why didn't the first ball just bounce and have momentum come in? The force of resulting motion equals mass times velocity. Don't forget it's a vector quantity, meaning that it has direction, and that's really important. This is Abe and Steve. Science class call 3. You thought the song was over, but we're not done. We still have to talk about the conservation of momentum, like I said before. Direction's really important, but if you don't have that, then the ball swinging down will just bounce back. But don't worry, momentum is what keeps the energy going, down the line of balls to the other side swinging. Hold up, the ball stop at the top of its arc. Isn't that breaking the universe's law? Wrong. That only works in closed system, but since there's gravity and air resistance, it's breaking free, and at the top of its arc, the energy is only potential, no kinetic or momentum. As it begins the cycle, the beautiful part is the elastic collisions. When two forces collide, the combined kinetic energy is the same as before. What do I mean? I mean if the balls hit another ball, then the ball goes swinging with the same energy as before. At least that's what it's supposed to be. Just kidding, that's impossible, because you can't forget about that one thing that robs the system of its freedom. Friction, robbing the system of energy, turning it into elastic collisions, so the energy difference goes where? When the balls clash, they vibrate to produce a burning heat, also creating the signature clicking sound, giving the name ball clicker. And on top of that, don't forget the cradle isn't always built perfectly. Human hands, so clumsy and weak, creating an imperfect system so bleak. And so I sing, spinning out rhythms so dark and bleak, about this ideal Newton's cradle system, robbed of its perfection and sweets. And so please, share this with your mates. This is Abe and Steve, giving you a rap about Isaac's cradle. Signing out. Hope you have a good day.